Welcome back to another edition of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate. So I'm not sure how this happened, but in the Pacific Northwest, it has become fall, basically overnight. And fall is my favorite season, so that's exciting. It also means that I'm going to have to find more long-sleeve shirts. Today, I'm wearing a shirt featuring one of my favorite fictional high schools, Bayside High. 80s and 90s kids will recognize this because Saved by the Bell was the best. And I still have a crush on Zach Morris. All right, enough about cheesy Saturday morning sitcoms from the past. Let's get into this week's dev news. First up, we will not have an episode of This Week on Channel 9 next week because I will be at Microsoft Ignite in Orlando, Florida, where it is not fall and is very hot. So Ignite runs from September 24th through 28th, and as I said, I'll be there along with the Channel 9 crew. So if you're in Orlando, stop by the podcasting stage where we'll be set up all week. And you'll be able to watch content from Ignite at Channel 9 next week, including the keynotes and select sessions. And we'll also be doing Channel 9 Live in between various sessions, featuring interviews with leaders from the community, executives, tips and how-tos. So be sure to check it out. In other event news, in October, as a continuation of the Microsoft Ignite and Pivotal Spring One platform events, my pal and Java CDA, Bruno Borges, will be hitting the road with four outstanding Pivotal developer advocates and engineers, bringing the latest and greatest about Spring and Azure to Java user groups throughout Europe. So Bruno and friends will be joining Java user groups between October 8th and the 19th to demonstrate how Java and Spring developers can bring reactive Spring Boot applications to the cloud. And there are 9 stops on this tour, kicking off in Dublin, Ireland, and then they're heading to London, Paris, Brussels, Utrecht, Dortmund, Frankfurt, Saarbrücken, which I can't say correctly, and then finishing off in Bern. So check out the description for a link that will give you information and all the dates and locations, along with sign-up news and sign-up links. And if you see Bruno in Europe, be sure to tell him how much you like TWC9. Also happening in October is Hacktoberfest. And Hacktoberfest is an annual celebration of all things open source, and it was started by GitHub and DigitalOcean back in 2014 to rally a global community of contributors. And last year's event had more than 30,000 contributors and more than 240,000 pull requests. So that's great. And this year, Microsoft is joining Hacktoberfest, thanks in no small part to my fellow CDA, Baron Furst. And this is how it works. So this October, so starting October 1st, ending the 31st, we will recognize anyone who submits a pull request to one of our open source projects with a special limited edition t-shirt. So whether you're a seasoned maintainer or new to open source, there's something for you. And our projects span nearly all areas of computing, from developer tools and frameworks like .NET Core and Microsoft Cognitive Toolkit, Visual Studio Code and Visual Studio Tools for Xamarin, to Kubernetes tooling like Draft and the Service Fabric Container Orchestra. So any contributions are welcome. So explore our GitHub repos, find something that interests you, and submit your first or maybe even your 100th pull request. And you can post any questions you have to the Hacktoberfest GitHub repo or tweet at OpenAtMicrosoft with the hashtag Hacktoberfest. And the t-shirt is designed by our very own Ashley McNamara, who is responsible for many of the great Go Gophers and Bit, our mascot for the Cloud Developer Advocate and Cloud Ops Advocate teams. So go forth and contribute. Speaking of GitHub, the GitHub engineering team has just published a blog post showing off GitHub Experiments, which is their new home for some of GitHub's most exciting research projects and the ideas behind them. And you can access the experiments at experiments.github.com, and links are in the show notes. But the one I want to highlight is the new demo for semantic code search. And there's a separate blog post explaining how the demo works, and I'll also have that linked in the show notes. But the TLDR is that using machine learning, the GitHub team is exploring how to build semantic representations of code that allow users to use natural language to search for code by intent rather than just keyword matching. And as I said, the links to all of this are in the show notes, but the demo is awesome, and I hope that this makes its way into the proper product in the future. In more AI-related news, Microsoft announced last week that it has acquired Loeb, a startup aimed at making deep learning simple, understandable, and accessible to everyone. So basically, Loeb is a drag-and-drop AI tool that has tons of potential. And it launched in beta earlier this year, and for now, it's going to continue to operate as before. And this is what the Loeb team wrote on their website. We plan to continue developing Loeb as a standalone service supporting open source standards and multiple platforms. So I love this. And last week, we discussed the big launch of Azure DevOps and focused a little bit on the Azure Pipelines product, the CI/CD part of the service. And this week, I want to highlight a blog post from Jeremy Epling that goes into more details about Azure Repos, which is the new Git service. And so this has unlimited free private repositories with collaborative code reviews, advanced file management, code search, branch policies, et cetera. And Azure Repos is great for small projects as well as large organizations that need native AAD support and advanced policies. So check out more details in the show notes. And in other DevOpsy news, that's a word, I guess, there are some great updates to CI/CD support for Jenkins with a new Jenkins Azure ACR build plugin now in public preview. And I've also linked to a blog post from Brian Benz showing off how to integrate Jenkins with Azure DevOps. So great stuff. In some Linux on Windows news, Microsoft has partnered with Canonical, the people behind Ubuntu, to bring an optimized Ubuntu desktop image to the Hyper-V gallery. And this will give an optimum experience when running Ubuntu desktop as a guest on a Windows 10 Pro desktop host. And so basically this means that in just a couple of minutes, you can have Ubuntu 18.04, which is a long-term service release, running in Windows 10 in a VM. So note, you will need Hyper-V for this to work, which means you'll need Windows 10 Pro or Education or Enterprise, and details on how to enable Hyper-V and how to get this set up and running with this optimized image are in the show notes. And don't forget, you can also install WSL or the Windows subsystem on Linux directly from the Microsoft Store if what you really want are the Linux command line tools. And in some Electron news, Electron 3.0.0 was released this week. And the biggest changes are to the Electron toolchain, which gets major updates, including Chrome version 66, Node version 10.2, and V8 version 6.6. And what impact this will have on apps running built on Electron, like VS Code, remains to be seen. But as I mentioned a couple of weeks ago, Visual Studio Code Insiders has already hinted that it's going to be putting Electron 3.0 in its next builds. So that means that we're all going to see the benefits in the future. And now it's time for my pick of the week. So despite my Twitter handle being @film_girl, I don't really geek out as much about movies as I should on TWC9. But that ends now because Marvel just dropped the first trailer for Captain Marvel, and I'm here for it. Starring Brie Larson as Carol Danvers, I'm all about the latest film in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. I also loved the great touch at the beginning of the trailer with the Blockbuster video, because who doesn't love defunct video stores of our past? Let me know your favorite MCU movie in the comments. So that does it for me. As I said, no show next week because of Ignite, but in the meantime, you can catch up on all kinds of great Channel 9 content by hitting that like button on this video and subscribing to this channel, Microsoft Developer, on YouTube. See you next time.